sheet. And it's all brought to you live on Sky Sports Box Office by Boxer Promotions and our promoter, Mr. Ben Shalom, and our sponsorship provided by Bet365, Arnold Clark, ICICB, Village Hotels, Everlast, and Wow Hydrate. Let's bring the stars of the show to the stage at this time. Coming out first from Sheffield, he's the former welterweight world champion, Kel Special K. His opponent to the microphones, ladies and gentlemen, from Bolton, the former light welterweight world champion, Amir King. About you, but I have to tell you, you know, when you say the thrill of victory, the agony of defeat, that's something that many writers here, the broadcasters, the promoters, and the fans will experience together. The fighters, each one will have the thrill of victory, one will have the agony of defeat. But as a fan, we're going to experience both, because through the years, we've both come to know these guys. We love them, we appreciate them. For me, I've introduced them in the ring and I've known them for many years. And it's just, while it's an exciting experience, it's gonna be a tough night for a lot of us because this is something we've looked forward to for so long. So let me just get things started and pass this on to my longtime friend of over 25 years from Sky Sports, the head of Sky Sports Boxing, Mr. Adam Smith.
Thank you very much. A pleasure to have the legend here back in the UK. Michael Buffer, fantastic. Just give you the big fight feel, doesn't it? It's been an incredibly exciting, enticing week here in the fabulous fighting city of Manchester. And the former headliners, Hatton, Hay, Froch, even Nassim Hamad, who's just called Ben's phone about 5 minutes ago, cannot wait for this. We've seen colossal, fiery grudge matches over the years. None may be more heated in recent times than Froch and Groves, of course. And as Ben and I drove past Old Trafford last night, the Ben and Eubank memories flooded back. October 1993, Ben was just born a week before that. He was 1 week old when that happened. Incredible. And now, after years of waiting for the most bitter rivalry of this modern era, we reach a conclusion in less than 60 hours on Saturday night. So to Ben Shalom, the CEO of Boxer, you made the fight happen, and it's your first Sky Sports box office event.
Yeah, wow, Sky Sports box office. Something anyone from my generation has grown up with. It's the biggest brand in boxing. It's grown the sport more than ever. It's the history of the 20 years, and it's been some great promoters that have carried that mantle from Frank Maloney to Frank Warren to then Eddie Hearn. It's special to be able to take this brand into 2022 now, into a new era where there's going to be 24/7 access, where there's going to be content, where there's going to be the greatest storytelling in British boxing. But we want to save it for special nights, and this is a special night. Khan v Brook, it almost feels strange saying it. It's a fight I've dreamt of watching, never mind promoting. It's a fight that has captured the imagination of the British sport for a long time. We started our company 4 years ago, about 200 yards from the Manchester Arena. This was a fight we talked about in the office long into the night. And when we got the chance over the past 6 months to actually try and make this happen, it's been relentless. It's been hard work. The teams have been hard work. And now we're here. It's unbelievable. We're three nights away. I mean, this was a fight that we always wanted to see. It has the narrative. It has the storytelling. You couldn't really make it up. The entertainment in this fight, two superstars. At the end of the day, it's a lad from Sheffield and a lad from Bolton that went on to achieve things that we could only dream of. it was almost too much for them to fight each other. There was almost too much to lose. They both went and conquered the world. But now we get to see it on Saturday night. It's going to be absolutely packed in the Manchester Arena on Saturday. I want to thank the fighters for wanting to take this opportunity and put it all on the line. It's something for the fans that we've been waiting for a long, long time. And lastly, I want to thank Sky Sports because I'm starting to see the scale of this thing. And I think without Sky Sports in British boxing, it would be a very, very, very sorry place. And they've been unwavering in their support over the past 6 months to build the stable and build boxing back up, and culminating in a night that means as much to us a boxer and to myself personally as it does to them. Thank you all for being here. Thank you for the teams. The fighters look in tremendous shape, and everything is set up perfectly for Saturday night.
Thanks, Ben. This is very personal for many of us at Sky. We followed the careers of both Amir and Kel for many, many years. And did we ever think this was actually going to happen? Well, it is on Saturday night. Let's get straight to the fighters, the gladiators that are putting it all on the line. It's all about this fight for legacy. Amir, first to you. As Ben said, the pair of you look in phenomenal shape. We saw little bits in the workouts yesterday in the packed Trafford Centre. How excited in your whole career are you for this night on Saturday?
I'm very excited. You know, this is a massive fight for me. My 40th fight. Being as a professional boxer for a very, very long time, and has to be one of the biggest fights of my career. Winning world titles is one thing. Going to America was my dream, to fight over there. And I did that. But this fight means a lot to me, my career. And that's one of the reasons I had to go back to the drawing board, change my whole training camp. And that's when I joined Team Bomac and Team Crawford. I went all the way to Omaha, Nebraska. And I just needed that motivation and that push. And I thought the only people who can do that for me is this team. And went back to the drawing board. And I think, you know, knowing that this is going to be one of the biggest fights in Britain gives you that extra push as well, that motivation. And being on Sky Sports, where everyone gets the opportunity to watch the fight, is going to be massive and amazing. I mean, you know, I'm just worried about one few things. I'm worried about Kel's health after the beating I'm going to be giving him come this fight night. I mean, look, I think the beating he's going to get is something that he's never had before. And all the talking he's been doing as well. You know, we are gonna definitely put him in his place, because it's been a very long time. I mean, like 10 years it's been going on for. So this is my time now to put him in his place. And, you know, one thing I want to say as well, another thing, I think Kel's always been very obsessed with my career. You know, he's been like a fanboy, which is honest truth. And, you know, I've been living in his head for such a long time that I think it's going to come stage where he's going to say, I mean, he needs to start paying me some rent. You know what I'm saying? So, but it's been like that. But, you know, we just need to go in there. Like I said, put all the words to a side. I think we've done enough talking. I just can't wait to get in the ring and, you know, do a job on him now.
But, Amir, what's fueled the fire, personally, for you?
You know what? I think it's more jealousy than anything. I mean, look, I've been on my own, having my own career. I've been fighting. I've been traveling to America. My dream was always to, you know, win a world title and also then fight in the likes of MSG, Madison Square Garden, fight at the MGM Arena, fight in Vegas, have your face lit up on the Vegas Strip. Obviously, Kel was over here. That's the reason the fight didn't happen then, is because I was already campaigning in America. I think now, as it's got to this stage where we thought, you know what, it makes sense having it. A lot of people might be saying it's too late, but now I think it's been massive. I mean, the outcome of this has been huge. And, I think it's the right time, the fight's happening.
What happens if you lose? Would you ever live with that?
I mean, look, it's a big thing for us both. I mean, if either of us lose, it's going to be something we're not going to be living with. We can't live with for a very long time. I mean, it's going to haunt us for a very long time as well. So I think, look, I'm going to put that in my mind. That's the reason I trained so hard, and I'm not left no stone unturned. I've done everything I needed to, because I know that, you know, I can't lose this fight.
Kel, let's bring you in. He says it's jealousy. He says the fanboy, you've been waiting and waiting and waiting for this fight. There's an obsession. There's something in you that has got to get rid of Amir Khan. And it's been burning for so, so long, hasn't it?
Yeah, listen, you know, he's known, it goes back from the amateur days. You know, he were always He boxed at 60 kilograms, I was 63.5. He used to win championship at the weight below, I used to win it the one above. You know, we went to England team, we shared, you know, the same room. You know, I know exactly what word, you know, and then obviously he did what he did in the Olympics, got a good sign-on fee, and we was with the same promoter, Frank Warren. We always got promised that we would fight down the line. But like he said, he said in many interviews, like, "Oh, he's Kell Brook." He said that he didn't even know who I was. You know, there's things like this, and you know, he's never given me that respect. You know, and he knows.
When you shared a room together.
We've shared a room together. You know, we've shared a room. We do an article in the boxing news when we're 18 year old. You know, like obviously we were going to be built and.
That doesn't sound right. Don't laugh. Listen, I ain't sharing a room with you. Trust me, I ain't sharing no room with you. I ain't sharing a room with you. Don't be saying that. That doesn't sound right, Kel. Especially with the stuff I've heard.
What have you heard? So,
I'm not going to go into that. Listen, we'll be fighting on Saturday, so don't be saying. Shane, you know what you should have said instead? You should have said, share the ring with him or something. But
share the room with him. Ain't sure what's on gay sites, wanking yourself off.
Okay, guys. Kel. Kel, come on.
Anyway.
Sorry. So listen. The talk is nearly over. Listen, the fight's here now. You know, I don't like him here. You don't like me. You're going to see an epic fight Saturday night.
What do you take with the fact that he says he's going to give you a beating that you won't recover from? And of course, for the loser, it is a very, very lonely place to be Sunday morning.
Well, listen, we're three sleeps away. We're three sleeps away. He's definitely going to sleep Saturday night. You know, when I smash him in. So listen, we're days away, and nobody's going to be interested. He can say what he's saying today.
But listen,
after Saturday, no one's going to be interested. You can go to Dubai and just carry on doing what you're doing.
That's your prediction.
That's the end of it.
But you know, when I ask one question, obviously we got everyone here. You know, I saw a video where you said that you're going to smash that Papa Dumb chin in. You said that, didn't you? I mean, it's quite racial, that is. I mean, so you saying
what,
that.
What are you trying to get?
What line are you trying to put down here? It's very sad saying that, because at the end of the day, you know.
So what are you trying to say? I'm racist.
Guys, let's stop the fight.
I mean, the way that you said that, I'm really sad.
Kel, come on.
You should not have said that.
Let's stop the fight.
Adam, can I just ask why you said that?
Let's stop the fight. Why did you say it? Kel.
Everyone knows they're very fragile, like your chin.
Yeah. Kel, you've been away, Fuerteventura. You put everything into this camp. Is it the best? Dominic was saying to me the other day, probably the best camp since Sean Porter. Is it the best you felt? The weight, we know, the 149, a slight issue here. How are you feeling in yourself compared to all the other great nights you've had?
Well, he made a mistake. You know, 7 months we've been talking about, you know, about this fight. You know, me, his team, my team. You know, I've been training because I knew that he was going to come off. You know, he got agreed and then he come back to the table and wanted to change the contract again. You know, I seen in the gloves are off that it says that I'm half broken. It seems to me that in his mind that he's only took this fight because he thinks I'm half broken, but he's made a massive mistake. He's made a massive mistake in this fight, a massive mistake, because you're going to see, you know, like we've been away in Fuerteventura for 6 weeks. We've been doing absolutely everything possible to be in the best possible shape for Saturday night, and the world's gonna see, you know, me go in there and destroy him.
And you'll destroy him, and you believe you'll destroy Kel, Amir?
100%. I mean, look, the hard work has been done, and we've done what we needed to do. We've trained very hard for this fight, and I'm sure he has as well. And you know, come fight night, the best man will win.
Let's bring the two dads in right now.
Enjoy the video. Feel free to hit the like, subscribe, and share. As always, if you want to support us to the next level, head over to the patreon.com/theboxingvoice. We have tons of exclusive from Border Wars, Entitled, betting shows. The list goes on and on and on. But in addition to that, if you guys have questions for fighters, trainers, and promoters, this is where you can submit them. We will run out, get these questions answered, and put it back on the show just for you guys. Appreciate it. Peace.